calling this meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Mr. Brooks?
Here.
Mr. Brown?
Here.
Ms. Crawl?
Ms. Crawl?
Here.
Ms. Davis?
Here.
Mr. DeFrancesco?
Here.
Mr. Johnston?
Here.
Mr. Lynch?
Here.
Ms. Tyson Wright? And Mr. Valesky?
So. Please stand for the pledge of allegiance for those who are sitting down. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Approval of the minutes?
Thanks, Al. Recommend approval of the minutes for September 8, September 6, September 22.
So moved.
Second.
We have motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Anybody out there?
Under presentations, we have Porter Brooks from Sagertown High School with an update.
Hello, my name is Porter Brooks, and I'm here to update you on what is happening at Sagertown High School. Sagertown is happy to welcome Spanish teacher Lisa Burdick to the staff. She has over 20 years of teaching experience, and her three children graduated from SHS. We also look forward to meeting music teacher Angela Graham on Monday. Welcome to SHS. On Wednesday, students and technology teacher George Nahe's class attended the MBA Manufacturing Day at the Erie Bayfront Convention Center. The exhibits, programs, and educational breakout sessions are designed for participants to experience innovative technology and learn about the many career opportunities in modern manufacturing. On October 6th, three of our gifted students traveled with other gifted students from the district to observe open heart surgery at Allegheny General Hospital. Junior Kylie Boring has been named the 2022-23 Miss Cancer Wishes. The Sagertown-based organization started at by SHS alumni Diana Blood has raised over $100,000 to fund the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Boring travels to events to promote the organization. Anyone who would like to make donations can visit cancerwishes.com. Both the varsity girls and junior high boys cross-country teams have won Region 3, each with a 4-0 record. Senior Joe Grundy has qualified for the PIAA State Golf Championship that will be held on October 16th through 17th at Penn State University's Blue and White courses. Grundy earned 8th place at the District 10 final after surviving a playoff with Mercyhurst Prep's Nick Momeyer. We wish him luck in the state tournament. The girls' volleyball team is currently undefeated in Region 3 with a 7-0 record and a 9-2 record overall. This is quite an accomplishment because they moved from single A to double A this year. Senior night for volleyball is tonight, and football is Friday night. Congratulations to all the senior fall athletes, cheerleaders, and band members. The October issue of the Panther Press will be released on October 31st. You'll receive your paper copy at the next meeting and can access the digital issue on the day of release. Thank you for your time, and we look forward to updating you next month. You can find regular updates about what's happening at Sagertown at thepantherpress.com and on our social media.
Thank you. Thank you. New in Northwestern Pennsylvania is the Northwest PA Class Act Emerging Leader. CLASS stands for Character, Leadership, Attitude, Service, Selflessness. This is a contest across the IU5 where every school district will nominate an individual to compete against other individuals from other school districts for scholarships. Our first Class Act Emerging Leader for the month of September is Cambridge Springs High School senior Haley Rogers. So Haley was nominated by Angie Mumford and Jason Presapora, and I'll just read a little bit of what they said. Miss Haley Rogers is an exemplary student at Cambridge Springs High School. She has shown a mature approach to learning in her entire academic career, and she continues to challenge herself daily with her honors and AP course load. I have worked with Haley for the past 2 years as a student in AP Place, Advanced Placement English. She's highly motivated to perform well above top and earn top grade. She's also motivated to learn. Acquiring the knowledge and skills taught in class are just as important to her as getting a good score. She's maintained over a 4.0 GPA and is president of the National Honor Society. While both academics and athletics are important to Haley, her true character is most remarkable. She's a caring and compassionate young lady who has a kind heart and wishes to make our world a better place. So congratulations, Haley, for being our first Class Act Emerging Leader. We have a certificate for Haley if you could just hand that to her. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
So Haley, as a senior, would you like to share any plans or thoughts for the upcoming school year? Next year, rather?
Yeah. I plan to attend the University of Central Florida and major in political science pre-law, and then attend law school and become a corporate lawyer.
That's pretty detailed. All right. Thank you very much. And next, you will have some regional coverage. I think we're going to have it on TV and some of the papers and whatnot, so we'll see you on the big screen. So thank you. There are no registered citizens' comments on agenda items. Are there any citizens here who wish to comment on agenda items? All right, seeing none, we'll move forward. Education report, item A, resolve the Pencrest Board of School Directors approve the student travel agreements for Junior Achievement to BizTown for fifth grade at Maplewood Elementary School.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Say aye.
Yep.
Motion passed.
Recommend approval of the athletic trip Sagertown High School to Sheffield for the tip-off tournament.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion approved.
Approve the attached Penn West University dual enrollment agreement.
So moved.
Second.
I'm sorry, with the plain intention. We have a motion and a second.
Yes.
And discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion approved.
Item D, recommend approval of the attached Bethesda Cooperative Agreement.
So moved.
Second.
And motion and a second. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
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 Motion approved.
Item E, recommend approval to accept a donation from Marquette Savings Bank to the Pencrest Cyber Academy, the amount of $7,000, to be used for the PCA drop-in center.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Discussion.
I'd just like to say thank you to Marquette for their donation. We appreciate it. Much appreciated.
All in favor? Say aye.
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 Item F, recommend approval of the attached MOU with CareStar Incorporated to assist families with access to county and Commonwealth services.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. And discussion. All in favor say aye.
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 Motion approved.
Item G, recommend approval of the following resource materials.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Discussion.
I have a question about item two. I'm not sure if that followed our procedures. It originally was listed as 109.2 or 109. I'm not sure where that was recommended, if went through the normal procedures for something to be approved.
It was discussed Monday.
Our policies involve educational professionals and administration being involved with the rationale for something. Was that followed?
Explain the rationale you expect.
To follow policy 109.2.
This is a resource material.
and policy 109. Go ahead.
The rationale number two is that it's an historical, it's more of an historical event that happened back in the 70s, I believe.
It was kids born in 1967. There was genital mutilation, and they went under psychological experiments where the psychologist was having the two twins act out sex acts when they were 6 years old. And, you know, I'm not sure exactly the point of this book. When I look, again, to go back to not necessarily what the point of the book is, but if we're following procedure. And when I look at resource materials, it's educational professional submitting it for...
It's very educational, my friend. It's very educational because this book, just like the...
I'm not talking about the book, I'm asking about if we followed the policy.
If
not the contents
policy,
of the book.
It's just like number one. It's educational because we have an obligation. Well, I'm the donor of the book. It's my opinion that the students, our students, need to know the history of what I called the genderism. And the book's about a young child that was the very first, where gender change actually happened. And the only thing is accomplished to let people know the history of it, about a doctor who believed that it could, this transition could happen, and the book explains it better than I do. So this is nothing but an educational book, just like number one, The Missing Semester.
I would just submit that the IU5 are educational professionals and that the donor of the second book is not. And my question again is on the guidelines. The assistant superintendent's recommendation, and it would be a rationale. A lot of the things you said about the book aren't necessarily true, but it's just, I just want to make sure we're following policy and this isn't just the...
The both books don't follow the policy requirement for the source material.
I'm not saying both books are. I'm saying that number two is, doesn't.
I just explained to you, both books have an educational...
I understand your opinion.
They have an educational purpose.
I'm just asking if it follows the policy. Can we ask the solicitor, does that seem like that?
You have the policy in front of you that you can explain the what you...
My legal opinion is no more valid than yours. I would say that maybe solicitor would have more...
Do you have anything else to say? Anybody else?
It's no different than the LGBTQ books that got slid in that we had a discussion on here a few months back. I didn't see any educational value in them.
This book, I mean, from what I've read, it is very positive for transgender people. It tells what it's like to have your gender and your genitals not match up. It was twins that won their... They used a laser circumcision to mutilate their genitals, and then there was a social experiment around it. So the policy says we approve resource material at a certain time and there's a procedure to do it. I just want to make sure we're following the procedure and our policy and not just going around it for one specific book. The content of the book I don't have a problem with. I'm asking for following policy, not what the book is about, not your opinion on the book, if we're following policy is my only question.
Do you have the policy that you think we...
109 and 109.2. Those are the two policies.
No, the specific. Be specific.
Let me read exactly the policy. The assistant superintendent's recommendation. Did the assistant superintendent recommend this book?
Can I interject my two cents?
Go ahead. Sure.
I guess I don't agree with any of what's being said, but what I am concerned about, and this becomes a very difficult situation because we all have very strong belief systems. That's why we're members of a board. That's why we put ourselves here. But the question is, are we following policy? Not, are we so concerned with something we do or do not agree with that we're going to just pull something out of a hat to counterbalance it? I've never heard of a board member just randomly taking a book off of the shelf and placing it into our library. We're professionals that prepare for that. And it works for us to bring a curriculum and bring resources to our students. So I don't want to get involved in the bickering and the banter that goes with this. I don't want any part of it, but I do want to make sure that we're following policy and we are going to bring a book, another book into our school.
So it says the adoption or change materials can be made without the superintendent's recommendation by two-thirds vote of the board, and the board motion to put it on last on Monday.
So in terms of the policy, the recommendation, the policy says that the recommendation should come from the superintendent, and the only way to get around the superintendent's recommendation would be a two-thirds majority vote.
Okay. Thank you.
Anybody else? All in favor say aye. Those who say that it's against, and they...
Let everybody have a chance to be heard.
I just asked that, yeah.
I know, but you can start talking to other folks. So, anyone in favor of the book, please indicate by saying aye.
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 And those opposed?
Nay. And this is just on two or on both of them?
On both.
Well, no, I think it would be on them separately, since there's really no issue with regard to the first one.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I mean, so I guess I'm not clear who voted yes and no. I've got three people on the phone.
7-1.
7-1
and Brian.
7-1 and one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Teresa Krall dropped off the line, so she's going to be here physically. So she's a no vote or a non vote. So it's 7-1.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine.
All right. One more vote. Just to, for clarity purposes, if we could vote on the other...
I'm the president of this board. The recommendation from the superintendent is both books. And both books, like I say, have the same scope, educational. So, you know, the vote right now should be for both, because the recommendation is from the superintendent, period.
Well, that wasn't a recommendation from the superintendent. That was the board.
That came from new business on Monday.
Yeah. So that's the board.
Yeah,
so putting the two items on the agenda.
Didn't you just read that you recommended the approval?
Resolved that the Pencrest Board of School Directors approved the following donated resource materials.
Yeah. And he didn't recommend it.
No.
Okay. All right.
So you voted on the controversial one.
So what I'm saying is, can we vote on the missing semester book from the IU?
Yes.
And just we'll vote them separate, and
that's fine.
The record will reflect.
Yep.
So
okay. So we voted. The first vote is for the number one. Now we're gonna
That was for number two.
We just voted on number two. So you're voting
now
on the missing semester donated by the
Morgan. Now we're gonna vote for number one.
Yeah.
All right. Do we have a motion?
So move.
Second. We have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Yes. Okay. Thank you. Facilities Transportation, item A. Resolve the Board of School Directors direct administration to coordinate a roof project at Cambridge Springs High School with Garland Roof Company, doing business Omni. Anticipate award in December 22 for summer project 23.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye. We have discussion.
If you want this, go ahead.
Yeah, I just have a question. Did we have three bids on this?
We're going to go out to
bid.
Going out to bid.
Yeah. Okay. We're just I misread it because I thought you was awarding this bid.
No. We're going to hope to award in December.
Gotcha.
Anybody else? All in favor say aye.
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 And opposed? Motion approved.
Item B, resolve the Board of School Directors engage Thomas and Williamson Project Management to conduct a planning study that includes demographics and enrollment projections, building and system capacities and program requirements and efficiencies at an estimated cost of $23,655.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Discussion. Well, I just want to say to everybody, this is the best expense that we ever did for the safety of our students.
Anthony. The plan and study, I've had several questions. This is not only to get our information that we need to better make decisions on where we go forward on projects from here on out. That's all this study is. It doesn't define anything. It gives us the information we need to make proper decisions, and that is it.
Anybody else? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion approved.
Item C, recommend approved purchase of the attached Visiplex and Halo quotes in accordance with the state PEPM contract.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion approved.
Item D, recommend approval of the contracted list of student transportation drivers.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Discussion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion approved.
Approve the attached parent provided transportation agreement for student A.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Discussion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion approved.
Item F is for information, so we're not voting, but we had some conversation on Monday and just wanted to follow back up. So administration is working with McClure to draft an addendum to the Maplewood and Sagertown Phase 1 and 2 GISA projects for additional window and door replacement. We anticipate with some luck to get a more detailed proposal to the addendum for November approval for work to begin in the summer 23. So we have reached out to McClure. They're gonna hopefully attend our November meeting and have updated information. If they don't have updated information by then to put, you know, numbers to doors, windows, et cetera, then we may have to come back or hold it off until December 8th. But again, we do want to get those prices in locked in at 22 instead of 23. Any questions? Treasury report, item A, resolve that we approve the attached treasurer's report.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Discussion, questions? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion approved.
Item B, resolve that Pencrest Board of School Directors approve the payment of the attached disbursements.
So moved.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Discussion? Questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion approved.
Item C, Board of School Directors approve the attached Act 57 of 2022 resolution.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion approved.
Item D, resolve that Pencrest Board of School Directors approve the contract with Burke 1 to print and mail the 22 Act 1 Farmstead Homestead applications as attached.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Discussion? I have a discussion. This item is always on, every year we have to vote to send out notification about the Homestead Act. And that's because a lot of people, you know, either ignore it or they forget, and we have to hire somebody to send the application again. So please, if you have a, if you own property and you're entitled to the exempt, the homestead exemption, please send your applications so we won't have to spend the money every year for this, for continuously, year after year. Anybody else, any questions or discussion? Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion approved.
Personnel report, I'd like to offer a consent agenda for all items A through J.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion approved.
Item 10, new business. The only new business I have is to approve the attached revised all hazards and emergency operations plan and the confidential functional annexes and school specific crisis plans.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
Have a motion and a second.
Yep.
And discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion approved.
Announcements, the board met in executive session on October 10 and 13 for personnel negotiations. We do have registered speaker comments. Mr. Grubbs, Cambridge Springs resident, has some remarks.
Good evening. Thank you for allowing me some time to speak with you. My name is Justin Grubbs. I've been a part of Cambridge Springs High School for the past 19 years as a teacher, coach, and currently assistant athletic director. My wife and I are both Pencrest graduates and proud parents of a 2021 graduate and a current sophomore at Cambridge Springs. I am speaking tonight on behalf of 211 members of the Pencrest Education Association who have dedicated their lives and careers to my children and all other students of this community. Our mission is to see every child reach their full potential, and we hold the belief that a high quality education is the foundation of a strong community. There is no greater investment in a community can make and in the quality of its public schools. An investment in public education benefits all aspects of our community, from the economic advantages of having an educated workforce to the civic benefits of fostering responsible citizenship. Together, the members of Pencrest Education Association are fully invested in the success of our students, our schools, and our colleagues. Our commitment to student success extends far beyond the closing bell and classroom door. Together, we go above and beyond what's called for in our contract to ensure that our students are prepared to reach their full potential and take their place as leaders in the community. This commitment also extends to our fellow educators and our families. As you know, we have been in negotiations with the district since January, and our members have been without a contract since the start of the school year. We are in attendance to show support for our negotiations team and appeal to you, the members of Pencrest School Board, to join us and working harder to find a fair compromise to the current negotiations. I'd like to thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Are there any residents that would like to speak on non-agenda items? You can just stand up and give your name.
Hi, my name is...
need your name for the record.
Oh, Travis Peters.
And Sadie Pollock.
Along with Eric Stutler.
All right.
So, hi, my name is Travis Peters.
And I'm Sadie Pollock.
And we are residents of the Sagertown community, and we are both students within the Pencrest School District.
Today, we want to acknowledge the current state of the Sagertown Music Department. First, we want to celebrate and welcome Miss Angela Graham to Sagertown to take up the music teacher position, and we're looking forward to work with her. The music program is something that is not just important in Sagertown, but to every other Pencrest school. However, the music department at Sagertown specifically has been neglected, and the current state of it now is why we have chosen to speak today. I've been in the music program for 5 years now, and over the years I've witnessed the overall neglect that the music program and its teachers have endured. Each year I know the marching band works so hard to accomplish everything that they have done, and this year has been one of the greatest years for our show. But it seems as if the school progressively gives the band less and less in terms of funding, transportation, and et cetera. The buses, for example, have been late almost every single time, and it is not the bus company's fault. On our way to our competition, we asked for a bus, and the school said that they would take care of it, and the result of this was that the bus did not show up for over an hour.
We ended up winning that competition that day, and a good reward would have been able to have our bus on time and not waiting for over an hour. Our band director, Jason Kapinchak, has put his life and soul into teaching every single one of us and making us enjoy what we do, even though he and the band receive almost nothing. Mr. Kapinchak makes less than a 15-year-old working a summer job for 3 weeks while he is running an almost dead music program and getting less and less in return. The band puts so much money to pay for props, competitions, instruments, and flags. We ask that the board gives a consideration of their marching band, not just their sports teams. We are a major part of the spirit of our school, and our support is dwindling.
I've been a part of Sagertown's music program for 8 years now, and over the years I've continually been ripped from countless opportunities with music, either because the district keeps switching their music teachers from school to school, or because they simply don't think it's important. This year, Sagertown did not have a music teacher ready at the beginning of the school year, and I'm very excited to work with a new teacher who is being approved today. However, during the absence of a teacher, a few other older students and I had the opportunity to help make music class actually happen instead of having study hall after study hall. I had the opportunity to work with the concert band kids and help them find their instruments, as most of them relied on the school for their instruments. However, when trying to find them instruments, I realized then how neglected the music program has been, as there were basically no instruments for the students to play, and the ones that were available were either rusty, bent, dirty, or broken. I question a lot about our school's music program. I question how long ago it was when instruments were bought for Sagertown schools. I question why Sagertown only gets one music teacher, while both Cambridge Springs and Maplewood both have two, one for band and one for chorus. The list of questions can go on and on. What we want for the school board to acknowledge today is that Sagertown's music department is in desperate need of help and repair. Many students have actually left the music department because of the continuous downgrade and neglect, and the numbers just keep going down. Because of the current situation, many students have lost interest in music entirely, but with your help and support, we can change that. But we believe for once that we should not focus on if the books in our library are too offensive or if a certain policy we put in stone will save us money. To forget subjects that are overall irrelevant to students, but rather focus on something that is actually important and is directly affecting students within your schools. If we focus on that and strive to make it better, we can assure you then that students will come back. So please support the music programs within your schools. Thank you for your time.
Any additional non-registered citizens' comments on non-agenda items? Board member remarks?
Mr. Brown, would you like to start?
Sure, I'll start. First off, I'm really glad to see all of you here. It's nice to have a full boardroom, and I would like to continue this tradition. You kids did an awesome job in your speech. Thank you. And that's one of the things that Mr. Drove, when he was president, always said. We need to hear the bad things. We always hear the good things. We never hear the bad things. So I encourage students, all of our schools, parents, come to meetings, talk, tell us. We don't know, we can't address it. And I'm being honest, I did not know this. But that is crap. Sorry to be blunt about that, but kind of blew up my speech a little bit here, but my focus tonight is that I have 12 more meetings to get taxpayers more involved in this district. If we don't start focusing on the future of our kids in the district, we are in trouble. We can't be focused on things that affect parents and students negatively. Our administration gets paid to do a job, and that should be the focus, or should be focused on what's best for our students, not easier on themselves. I've said for years, education is like construction, or like constructing a building. We are in charge of the foundation, and if you know construction, you know foundation is key. Reading, writing, math, social skills, that is all the concrete rebar in the foundation. That's what you guys need to continue on with life, and that's what's important. Rules seem to be made by people with no regard to child development or input from teachers' responsibilities. It's time we start acting like the community and treat our students with priority. I'm challenging everyone in this room to get someone involved. I want these meetings full so we need larger spaces. I'm also challenging teachers to encourage student involvement. I'd love to see a few students from each school at every meeting and hear you guys speak and tell us what's going on. I'm also asking people to start thinking about running for school board. We have 6 seats available next year. I would love to see 20, 30 people on the ballot. And I do believe in term limits. That's why I'm not running again. I've had my 2 terms. I think we need young blood on here. We need parents who have skin in the game, parents and are with children in school. Now we have I'm gonna skip that. Last but not least, I'm begging everyone to get out next month and vote. This election is important. We have many agendas to do with education, to do with our economy and everything. And it is our civic duty to get out and vote. So everybody out, please do that in November. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. You stole some of my good points.
Well, I had more, but Justin stole some of mine.
Well, I don't know what we can do about Justin, but you and I can coordinate going forward. It is good to see more student updates here. I'm glad to see the Segertown kids here. I'd like to see, we used to have more Cambridge and Maplewood kids come and give updates on what's going on in the school. So, you know, if we can reach out and try to get more kids, since we do have a lot of educators here in the room, if we could reach out and get some more student updates. Now I'm gonna talk to the Segertown representative. He did a great job tonight. His dad should maybe teach him how to shave, but other than that, I thought he did a great job. I'm lucky enough that at Segertown, that they asked me to go and announce the Segertown Little Gritters games, and I get to go and sit there and be in the score up in the press box and see all of our kids out there playing. And it's 4th, 5th, and 6th graders. I got to see all 3 of our schools play this year. And on last night, I went up and the flag football team was playing. Flag football has a special place in my heart. I started it with some really great people. I was trying to talk to one of the other parents probably 10 years ago. We used old jerseys and some flags we found and a couple of footballs we went and bought from Dunham's. And we had 3 teams playing at the time. We had 15 kids, and we had over 50 playing last night. And Maplewood, I think I heard, has over 70 kids. I can't speak to how many are at Cambridge, but I know that, you know, the kids at the young age are involved, and this is where it builds into being involved in your community. And ideally, the reason we have sports isn't just to learn how to be good at tackling, but all the ancillary benefits being involved in sports. I would like to, and this hurts me as a Maplewood graduate with a son who plays for Segertown, but Cambridge Springs did win the mythical Pencrest Cup by defeating all of the Pencrest teams. Last time I saw that cup was in the trophy case out of Maplewood. I don't know if we want to break that out and put it in Cambridge, but if we could make that happen, I think that would be great. I'd like to thank Coach Walters and Coach Wise for all the time they put into Segertown baseball. They've both been great members of the community and mentors for our kids. I'd also like to acknowledge Mark Giroux. I don't ever see school board members come back once they're out. Apparently he has an itch he's not done scratching, and maybe we'll see him on I can get 10 signatures to get you back on the ballot, I promise you that.
Yeah, thank you.
You know, to touch again on what Mr. Brown was saying, you know, we need more people involved in the school board. We need people that have skin in the game, which is our kids. We need people that are focused on getting our teachers, our administrators, and our students what they need inside the classroom, and not just focused on what's happening in the boardroom. What happens here is really ancillary to what happens in the classroom, and we need to get our focus back on the students. And that's all. Thank you.
It's very pleased to see you come up. I know it's a little nerve-wracking sometimes to come and speak to this many people. I've done it myself before I get back. But I also come from a very musical family, and I understand that music is extremely important. And we just thank you for coming and sharing your thoughts on that. I also wanted to offer congratulations to teacher Patricia Retloff for winning the Golden Apple Award. That was a very special award to be able to win, especially by a student that was a student of hers several years prior. Also, an additional congratulations to Haley. That was a terrific honor. And finally, a thank you note to Marquette Savings for their generous donation to the PCA.
Thank you. Mrs. Davis?
Ms. Davis?
Jennifer?
Nothing.
No comments?
Nothing. Thank you.
Okay.
Mr. Lynch? Any comments?
I have nothing to add today. Sorry.
Thank you.
I'd like to congratulate Ms. Haley. That's awesome. And encourage the rest of our kids to strive for that type of thing. Acknowledgement to our school, we're proud of you. I'd like to thank the other students that come forward and brought it to our attention. A couple of years ago, Mr. DeFrancesco and myself was invited out to the awards banquet at the Maplewood Band Recognition Dinner, and we're very much behind the music program. Many of you don't understand that he's been struggling to find teachers, and we at the last minute got this music teacher. We're not trying. There's just a strong shortage of teachers right now. And the music program is important to us. Some of the stuff that you mentioned we weren't aware of, like Mr. Brown said, and that's unfortunate. We'll have to start working on that now that we have it brought to our attention. I'd like to thank Mr. Brooks for coming out and sharing with us again this month. I'd like to thank the teachers that came out tonight. Appreciate your efforts. I grabbed this book on Monday night, and I'm assuming this book was recommended by Mr. Newman, and I'm not sure. But I took it home to read it, and it's a very, very interesting book. And right inside the second page, it really caught my attention. This is just a couple of sentences. 77% of Americans right now are stressed over finances, and I'm sure it's probably higher than that. 69% of Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. 54% of households spend more than they make each year. That's why we have such a high credit card, and that's the last one. Student debt has increased to an estimated $1.5 trillion just in 2020. The sticker price for college education has increased 370% over the last 32 years. And right now, the total credit card debt is approaching $1 trillion. This is the kind of stuff that we should have been teaching the kids. And a lot of the parents need to grab hold of this book. I was in financial services for a long time. I'd like to thank Mr. Newman for bringing this to our attention. It's not going to benefit the little kids so much, but our high schoolers, some great information. The book even touches on college there. I've been a big proponent of the technical school. A lot of these kids coming out of the tech are making some really nice salaries and not carrying a load of college debt. So I thank Mr. Newman for recommending that book, and I think a lot of the parents ought to get it. It's kind of a deceiving title, Missing Semester, but I don't know about the rest of you folks, but when I was in school, we never got taught any of this stuff, and it's a shame because this is the kind of stuff that prepares you for the day-to-day life. So I'd encourage each of you to, if you get a chance, to read that book. That's all I have.
May I add something to that, Mr. Johnston? Mr. Johnston, talking about college debt and how much that's gone up, as you saw, we had an agenda item today, renewing our agreement with Penn West as far as starting up with dual enrollment. I'm a huge advocate of dual enrollment, so with as many teachers as we have here, I would ask that that would be promoted in the schools. I think we're going to be rolling out some promotions in Penn West. I think it's going to have some promotions too, but I can save students thousands upon thousands of dollars after graduation. So I just highly would recommend that, and that that information be given to the students, yes, to save them lots of money. So I'll add that.
Thanks for the info. Mm-hmm. Mrs. Pearl?
Well, hi. I was on the phone and I'm here. My mom duties came first, so I appreciate you guys being patient with me. As Mr. Brown mentioned, more parents need to be involved in the school board, and I am a parent of two Sagertown kids. I've got one in elementary school and one in high school. Tonight we played at Seneca Wattsburg, so I was up there and zooming down here. Hopefully it wasn't speeding, but it's okay, right? We're here.
You didn't get caught.
Okay. Thanks, Mom. But a couple of things I just want to make mention of. I know I follow the Panther Press on Facebook frequently, and I know that we appreciate the newsletters that come to the board. And so I follow that. And there are some things on there that I don't think have been mentioned yet tonight, like Joe Grundy with the golf. Mm-hmm. He was going to States. I'm not even sure how that outcome came, but I read that on Panther Press. So, I mean, these are things that, you know, are good things that happen with our district. I haven't read much about Maplewood or Cambridge, but I'm sure if it was on there, I'll find it. The other thing was, of course, the band that you guys came to talk about. You guys had some success in some competitions, which is fabulous. There was a couple articles on Panther Press about that, which I read as well. So, congratulations to that. And then the cross-country team. They had some success too, I think. Sam Hetrick and Brenna McRae, and I'm trying to think of the girls, Cameron and Reese, and somebody else was mentioned. Mila, was it? I can't remember.
Mila Bland.
Mila, that was it. I know I read the names. But they did great at some of the invitationals. I think it was like Cochran Tim. My son used to run cross country, so I kind of follow that too. The boys soccer team's not doing so great. It's a building year this year, but the girls soccer team's doing pretty well. And football, I try to follow as well. So, I mean, there's a lot of activity going on. And I really do encourage, like what Tim Brown said, and even Jeff, because we're active in the district. We are here. I wasn't able to be present last month because, again, my son's in soccer and I'm running to the games. But I do participate by phone. So if there are parents or teachers that may not have students, but, you know, live in the district, you know, get involved in the school board. We would really appreciate it. I work full-time, I'm a mom full-time, so this is just extra, and I enjoy doing it, but it is a lot of work. But it's what makes our district run, and we appreciate the teachers, we appreciate the aides, the cafeteria workers, everybody that comes together to make the education for our kids something that's successful. And I truly do appreciate it. And as Amber mentioned, Mrs. Rushloff, she had my sons in elementary school, and she's a fabulous teacher, so I'm really glad that she won that award. But did she come to me? Is she here? She's not here to me. All right. So, but anyway, it's good to have some great teachers in the district. We really do have some great talent. But as Bob mentioned, the talent pool, the teachers are getting, there's not many people out there applying for work. So if you know of good people, we are looking for some. I think they were a couple posted, you know, that we're looking to fill. So if you have anybody that you want to recommend, send them to the website. We certainly would want to take a look at them. So, but thank you all for coming. I do like the country. This is great. So, thanks.
Thank you. Well, first I have to congratulate Ms. Rogers. I must admit that you impressed me. And you definitely would have been a valedictorian if we had that. And most of our members had touched a lot of subjects, but I want to bring it to the attention what October 12th really means and should mean to a lot of Americans. Yesterday was the anniversary of Christopher Columbus. It was an individual that took the chance to go west in order to find a way to to continue their commerce with the nation on the east side, like India and China. But he ran into a problem by running into a new land. Christoph Colossus took a chance and discovered the world, the new world, that made it possible for all of us to be here today. Yes, it's true that some people despise this man because he dared to cross the ocean, that everybody thought that the world was flat and they would plunge right on the edge of the world, but it didn't. And too many people, you know, they try to destroy his reputation for acts that he had nothing to do with it, but somebody else did it. So I think it's important for our students to remember who Columbus was, why he did it, and be thankful that he did it. Because if you really think about it, you know, we have a population of 350 million in the United States alone, not just the Americas. Can you imagine if there wasn't a new world where all 350 million people will be today? It's pretty hard to surmise. But anyway, I think that Columbus is an important individual because a lot of Americans through the ages didn't explore the innovations that made our life a lot easier today. You take the Wright brothers, Ford, Henry Ford, Thomas Edison. They were the first ones that ever came up with something new and made our life a lot easier. So, you know, that's something else I think our students should know, that they are the future and they can contribute a lot, just like Columbus did and all the other Americans that came up with innovations that not only made our life easier, but the world life. The other point that I have to make is that our precious assets of the parents of these districts are your young people. And we have an obligation to make sure that you all get educated and you're all going to be ready for a fruitful future that will come in your life. It's very important to me to know that the administration does everything they can do to give the right education, and eventually you'll be able to go on in the world and do whatever you want and create a future for yourself, and some of you will get married and have children, and for your children too. A good example is Miss Rogers right there. She's a very example that hopefully most of you will follow and be glad that we have somebody that really works hard and betters herself. And with that, thank you for coming, and thank you for the job you're doing for Pancrest and the parents and the children and the students. I don't mean to offend any of you teenagers that are not children anymore, but I'm proud of all the things you're doing, and hopefully you continue to do the best you can. And thank you. And with that, do we have a motion to adjourn?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
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 Motion approved.